I put my new American-made shovel to good use on this trip. Join us while we get into and out of some sticky off-road situations on our awesome trip to the Oregon Dunes National Recreation Area.
Go backwards.
Welcome back to Muddy Ruttzz Overlanding. Well, we came up to Oregon Dunes with our Gladiator and our Xcenture XC3 trailer. And we're driving around here in the dunes, and we got ourselves in a little trouble here. This low-hanging tree.
Yeah.
I'm gonna keep shoveling down here farther. Tried backing up, it did not work. My wife said, looks like we could clear it. I said, you know what, let me dig a little hole here. Spent a little time digging, lowered the hole. The Jeep went through just fine, cleared pretty well. Now I gotta get this trailer to clear. I don't wanna do any damage to this rooftop tent. So now we're gonna see. Hang on, sweetie, hang on. Okay, go ahead. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Oh, hold it. Go backwards. Backwards. Okay, hold that.
That should be enough.
Yeah, I think so. Go ahead real slow, sweetie. Nice and easy. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So far so good, keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Awesome. Take her out of here. Keep going. Woo. Wow. All right, definitely wasn't gonna work driving backwards up that hill. I'll show you guys. Definitely wasn't gonna work driving up this hill. It's hard to tell in the video, it's kind of steep though. Anyways, I was thinking traction boards, I was thinking chainsaw, and finally shovel. And it's one of my things I always say, when you're in trouble, your first tool is a shovel. And in this case, it worked. This is our camp at Horsefall Sand Camping in the Oregon Dunes Park. We set up camp, unhooked the trailer, and then went out and did some exploring in our Jeep Gladiator ecodiesel. Then it was time to come back and start making some dinner. Tonight was roasted asparagus, veggie burgers, and for my wife, she had brought along some squid steaks to put on the barbecue grill. Bummer, I forgot the ketchup, but at least I had some hot sauce to put on them. Getting a little video of you making the fire, sweetie. Oh. While I was cooking my wife's squid steaks, she was getting a campfire going. It's getting harder to find places where you can camp and have a campfire, but out here is no problem as long as it's in a pan or a fire pit. My wife makes delicious homemade kimchi, and we finally found the perfect container to carry it in our cooler on our off-road trips. Another great camp dinner, easy cook, and easy cleanup. This is a really busy OHV with tons and tons of dunes you can drive over, lots of trails. This is our camp spot. Over here is a day-use parking lot. A lot of people are coming after work and bringing their buggies and their side-by-sides and their motorcycles. This was a pretty nice camp. It quieted down around 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. Sun was out till after 10, actually. And we set ourselves up a nice little camp. This is space number 125. Wrapping it up now, we're gonna do some driving around, but we're gonna go ahead and put our trailer in the day-use parking lot because there's a lot more people over there. This spot is kind of remote. We're gonna put our trailer over there with all our stuff and it's probably gonna be a little safer. We're gonna get out and do a little more exploring today, and it should be a great day. There's some very nice camp hosts staying at the day use parking lot. And they said they'd watch our trailer and keep an eye on our stuff, and they helped me get oriented the day before. I always carry 5 gallons of extra diesel on my trailer, and I decided even though I had a pretty good amount of fuel, I might as well go ahead and throw that 5 gallons in the Jeep before we took off for the day, not knowing where we were going to go, what we were going to end up doing, or how long we'd be out. There's a whole story on filling the Jeep with diesel from a Gerry Can and modifying the spout to make it fit, but that's going to be a whole video all to itself eventually here in the future. A couple times I didn't fill up my Gerry Can on certain trips we were on, and I ended up regretting it and just barely making it to get more fuel at the gas station. Now it gets filled up every single time. If you're finding value or enjoying the video, please smash that thumbs up button, leave a comment, and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Before hitting this trail, we messed around in some steep dunes. And just a word of warning to anybody that hasn't been out here, close your windows before you try climbing dunes. You may end up like me with tons of sand inside your vehicle. We were having a great time blasting across the dunes. And then we got a little close to a tree island and ended up almost taking a dive right into it. My wife cut the Jeep hard to the left at the last minute, so we didn't end up sliding down into that tree island. We avoided disaster for the moment, but our Jeep was definitely stuck and on a very steep slope that the video just doesn't do justice to how steep that slope actually was. I carry a dead man sand anchor in my recovery kit, but my first thought was I'll throw 4 traction boards, one under each tire, and see how that works out first. I was a little rattled at first, but I got out, looked at the situation, and realized even if the traction boards didn't get me out of there, I knew I had my winch and my sand anchor that I could do some self-recovery with. I always carry 2 traction boards in the vehicle, and I have 2 other traction boards that are strapped to the top of my rooftop tent on my X-Venture X-V3 trailer. I was glad I had the presence of mind when we dropped our trailer to grab those 2 extra traction boards because I definitely needed them at this time. I shoveled a lot of sand out from in front of the tires to give the traction boards good position and jam them right underneath the bottom of the tires. I got the sand dug out from in front of the tires, got the traction boards all set up. It looks like we're about ready to make our first attempt at getting unstuck. I take one last look around the Jeep, make sure everything looks good, and then I'm going to jump in, put the Jeep in 4-wheel low, lock the front and rear lockers, and then I'll be ready to see if this Jeep would crawl out on top of these traction boards. It was just about then some folks in an ATV rolled up. They had a pretty sweet rig with a winch and offered to help. So let me give this a shot and see what happens first. Here we go. I'm counting on the torque from that diesel motor to pull me out without spinning those tires. Awesome. We're out. I didn't spin the wheels on top of those traction boards and wear them down. Came out real nice using all that torque from our 3-liter diesel Jeep motor. Let's see that one more time. How nice that Jeep came out of that predicament. Not the worst predicament you could ever be in, but everything worked out. I carry a lot of recovery gear that I don't use very often, but when I need it, I'm glad I have it. Time to pack up the gear and resume our trip to Hauser Beach. The trail to Hauser Beach runs right past a little store called Dune Bugs ATV Rentals. The guy there is a really nice guy. Stop and get a cold drink or ice cream when you're there. We visited, and the owner showed me his Project 53 Willys Jeep truck that he's building. I made a separate video of my visit, showing some pictures of his Jeep build. You can check that out in the link that appears above. The trail to Hauser Beach was well marked, about a couple miles of driving through the sand. We had driven through sand before on the Mojave Road and other places, but this is a lot different out here at Oregon Dunes. We drove a good long ways down the beach with ATVs passing us and us passing groups of ATVs, having their lunch and just hanging out at the beach. Then we made a big sweeping U-turn so we didn't get stuck, so we could head back down the beach. Stopped and got out, walked around for a little while on the beach, took a whole bunch of pictures. It was a phenomenal place. We could have driven a lot farther, but we didn't really have the time to do it today. This was our first visit to Oregon Dunes National Recreation Area, and we didn't even decide on this exact place to come until we were partway up the Oregon coast. We'll be back to explore many more of the miles and miles of trails that are out here in this huge recreation area. We know a lot more about the layout of the campsites. I think we'll find a more remote campsite next time we come here. Make your reservations at recreation.gov. That's a sore subject with me I won't get into right now. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. And don't forget, the best is yet to come.